Okay, so I think I am live again. So now what I want to know is my screen facing the right direction? Let me refresh my screen. Can't tell what's in the camera until my there we go. It refreshed. Yes, it's facing the right direction. Whew. Awesome. Okay, yay, I'm not sideways. Okay, I need a minute. I gotta plug in my computer power. It's a good thing I noticed. We'll give everybody a couple minutes to get in here since I had to stop the other live stream and restart. Let's see. Okay, we have power. Now let me look for comments. Yes, okay, everything's working. Okay, so can you guys hear me now? Let me make sure my computer is muted. Yep, it is. Okay. Oh, is somebody asking how I got my order so quickly? Yes, I paid for overnight shipping. I really need to be able to work on this stuff this weekend. Yes, you can hear me now. Okay, sorry about that earlier. Have no clue why it didn't work. Perfect. Okay, we'll give everybody a couple more minutes to get in here, and then we will start. I want to view this larger. Let's see if I can do that. I don't know how. Oh well, oh well. Oh, it won't work on your iPad? But you can leave a comment, but you can't watch it. Gail, maybe if you did you click on the little arrow thing in the middle? I could run upstairs and get my iPad. Is anybody on here on an iPad? Do you have any suggestions? Okay, so you are on an iPad. Do you have any suggestions for her? I don't know. Okay, so we're going to get started. I think you can tag friends on here. I'm not sure. You know, the beauty of this, though, is that I actually can see your comments on my computer, and my iPhone, of course, is up here above my head recording. So I can't really see what y'all are seeing because I'd rather be able to view the comments than actually the screen. So since I can see the comments, if you guys would just do me a favor, and if I'm out of the camera view or if I need to move to the left or to the right or add some color or anything, just leave me a comment and tell me. Because I had no clue earlier today I was filming sideways. But, oh well. It's kind of funny now that you think about it. So this morning I had just gotten my box in and I opened the box in front of everyone. I used my handy dandy scissors and cut everything open. And I swear I think I talked 100 miles an hour. So it is 7:40 here in Kansas. I'm a little tired now, so I'm not going to talk 100 miles an hour, but I am still just as excited. So anyway, we're going to start with the stamps because stamps are my favorite. And if you watched it earlier, I'm pretty much going to be doing the exact same thing I did this morning. I'm just going to go through all of the product and ooh and ah and share my favorites. So, and the reason that these are on top, these three, I think might be my most favorite. I don't know. I kind of changed my mind. So I say I change when the wind blows. But for now, I love the cookie cutter Halloween and the cookie cutter Christmas. And I hope I'm in the camera view. Oh, thank you. I love the Bella set too. So here is the matching punch for these two stamp sets. They are simply a must-have. Love them. So, Eskimo, Gingerbread Man, Santa, Reindeer, this is a bear, Dracula, Mummy, Scarecrow, Skeleton. Anyway, okay, so love. And I've already showed you the punch, so I'll set those aside. And that's one of the things I didn't get, was a place to put everything once I covered it. This is another really cute Halloween. I love these. So I was saying earlier that I could stamp this happy, spooky, creepy, scary Halloween, and then stamp like this little skull or this little pumpkin. I love the little spider, the little bone. If you look at it really closely, there's some really cute images in there. Now this one I got, I like it. I kind of love it, but I probably won't use it as much as this one because it won't fit in a punch. And if you know me, you know I'm a punch girl. Love this one, and it matches. Now see, I did get myself a little organized. So it matches the Home Sweet Home Thinlets. And, okay, so I can show you the cover of the catalog, but I'm not real sure where I stashed that thing. Oh, well, I'll post it on my blog. You can make a Halloween house, a gingerbread house. They're so stinking cute. So it's going to be a must as well. Oh, I got to look at the comments real quick. Oh, bring it closer. Okay, so you mean bring it up closer like this, Angela? I think. Is that good right there? I'll wait to... All of these are new. Everything I'm showing you is brand new. Yes. Okay, so how's that one? So this is called the Holly Berry Happiness, and I love this right here, and I love the bow. So you can expect, yes, there's Halloween paper. There's this whole stack right here is all brand new paper, and this is not my duplicates. This is all our paper, which is awesome. So this little bow right here is this punch right here. And I, even if this right here had not been in there, I think I would have bought this just for the bow. It's super cute. Okay. Next one, this one, Hang Your Stocking. It has a matching framelit. And I think earlier this morning, I accidentally called it a punch. Let me look for it. I got it right here. Yep. Yep. So here it is. Isn't that awesome? Oh, hopefully I'm in the view. If I'm not, let me know. I see the thumbs up from Angela, so thank you. So there's that. Now this one. Okay, so I went round and round on this one. To be honest, it makes... I love this Merry Christmas, and I love this one, I love this one, I love this one, I love the reindeer. And I don't know why I kept questioning myself, but it has this awesome thinlet. I think that's what it's called. Is it a thinlet? Yeah. And if you look on the catalog, which I don't have it right here, I'll look for it when I get done going through the product. But see Santa's face? It makes such a cute, simple, quick card just using this, and then you would just stamp this underneath it or this. So the sample in the catalog really sold this set on me. I might not have bought it if the sample hadn't been so darling. Let's see. Can someone post a picture or video of a layout in their planner using stamps like these? Yeah, I can't help you on that one. Okay, so Yummy Like Christmas. I ordered this one for Have Yourself a Yummy Little Christmas and Yum and this little mixer. I have a KitchenAid mixer because I bake during the holidays. my family would say I used to bake, but I'm starting to bake again. Stitched with Cheer. I love this set. These little trees, star. I love these greetings here. And I think, does this have something that goes with it? Oh, it does. The project kit, which I think I failed to show that. No, I showed it this morning. And what I said was I needed to film a video because, yeah, you can't really see much. So I'll do a video on making those projects. And this is the stamp set. Okay. Shake and celebrate. I'm trying to let y'all see it and then me read it at the same time. So I ordered this one mainly for all those greetings. They're fabulous. Be merry. Christmas cheer. Happy birthday. Christmas bells are ringing. At this very special time of year, celebrate. You're brilliant. And then I like these little teeny tinies. I'll be honest and say I'm not sure I use the cake. I might, but I also like the bows. And this also has a framelit as well. And it is called the Shaker Shape Framelits. So very cute. Okay, what's the name of the set with the Santa? That one is called Greetings from Santa. Okay, Merriest Wishes. And I think this one also has framelits. And I didn't really mention that this morning. I forgot to say, oh, this stamp set has framelits. It does, and they're really cute. I'm not going to take them back out. This morning, I kind of had stuff everywhere. It looked kind of crazy in here. Okay, so Candy Cane Christmas. Love it. Oh, it's so cute. And, of course, we have washi tape and this darling paper. Anyway, I'll show you more. Wonder of Christmas. She's just too cute to not get. Jolly Friends. Okay, so, has a punch. And you're just going to put a scarf or a hat on all of these. And it's going to be super cute. I was saying earlier today, some people were like, they don't like him. And I'm like, just cover his head up with one of these hats. He's Santa Claus. Put a hat on him. It's going to be really cute. I love it. And I think this guy's really funny. Okay, let's see. Merry Mice. Isn't that so cute? Okay, so I'm going to give you a suggestion too. On this, you're asking about what the name of the framelit is. It is. It's Detailed Santa. Sorry about that. On this, you don't have to do all the coloring. I noticed on one of the samples that this little guy was just stamped, and the only thing that was colored was the ornament, and it really made the ornament pop. So if you're not a fan of coloring, which I am, you don't have to color all of the parts. You can leave some of them blank. It'll be okay. I love this one. Where's my tan? Here it is. Okay. So, 10 of Tags. The font is fabulous. This one says, go ahead, tear it open. Spread some Christmas cheer, making spirits bright, warm wishes and mistletoe kisses. This is for you. I love it. And then this darling tan, I love it. But wait till you see what's inside. So it's got these little teeny tiny tassels and some twine. And look at this little washi tape. Some stars. Anyway, I love this and I love the tan. Who doesn't love tans? Okay, I'll do a video on that too. Okay, this one is called Happy Ornament, and I got this one for just a really simple, elegant card, and I will be honest and say that all I'm probably going to do is emboss it with this wonderful new Real Red. And this is not actually embossing powder. This is glitter. So I'm actually not going to emboss it with this since that's glitter. But I'm going to just emboss this with whatever color I decide to go with. Because, well, you could color it. But it would look really beautiful just embossed. Yeah, I've lost my words because I'm like calling something something else. It's not embossing powder. I think I called it embossing powder earlier too. Festive season. I can't remember what I was going to say about this one. I ordered this one because it goes with this. The festive stitch and thinlets. Yeah. And what I was telling everyone earlier is that you don't have to do the stitching with thread. You could just connect the dots with your marker. That's what we used to do in the old days. Let's see. I forgot to look for questions. Sorry about that. I keep hearing something beep. I don't know where it's coming from. Wrapped in warmth. I'm still looking for that noise. Yeah, I just love this one. Can't explain why I got it. I like it. That's why. Oh, okay, so this one. This one makes you smile. So I got this one for all of the greetings and for the teeny tinies. So like I said this morning, I can stamp this little teeny tiny tree with this Have a Happy Holiday. I love making 4x4, 4 1/4 cards. And so this would be so cute with a little Have a Happy Holiday. I don't know if I use the camper. I like it. It's cute. And if you want to see what size it is, there it is. It's so cute. Reminds me of the houses last year. This is a nice background stamp. Oh, you're going camping tomorrow? You must have good weather. It's too hot here. Merry Medley. This would be really pretty. Stamped in just like crumb cake and then stamped on crumb cake, so it'd just be like a watermark. I love this Halloween image. I'm going to show you the size of it. So that's how big it is. So this will be really nice for treat bags. I always thought we would have a camper because we used to always go camping, but our last few camping trips that we went on, our last one that we went on, it rained 8 inches in less than 24 hours. So, we don't go camping. We got a house. Okay, this one right here, you're going to see me use this one. I have plans for this stamp set because it has, this is the so cute, Vampires, Witches, and Ghosts, and the little boo. So it has Halloween, Thanksgiving, and Christmas, and the font's really nice. I love it. What's it called? Sweet Seasons. This one is the Paisleys and Posies, and it has a framelit also, so it's called the Paisley Framelits. Very beautiful and elegant. And this one right here, I was thinking I can't decide. So I could use this for the blessing mix this year, or I could use this one for the blessing mix. So, I don't know. We'll see. And now that I know that I really do like this paper after all, I could use that for my blessing mix. Basket of Wishes. Again, like one of the other sets, you don't have to color a lot to make this look good. You could just stamp this basket in like Early Espresso, stamp the little strawberries right on top, and just lightly color it. Okay, I love these. Oh, I love Halloween. You guys know that. Ghoulish Grunge. Love it, love it, love it. So that's like little accents. And then Spooky Fun. So this one, and I can't remember if I explained this morning. Oh, I did. Okay, so what I want to explain is that in this framelit set, it's called Halloween Scenes. You have the tree and the fence. You don't need a stamp for the tree and you don't need a stamp for the fence. If you look at the samples in the catalog, you'll see that this cutout of basic gray and this cutout of crumb cake or Dijon or whatever, delightful Dijon or whatever, that you don't have to stamp those. Just cut them out with regular cardstock. So then this image and the witch, so there's four, and the bat, they do have a framelit and a stamp. Okay, does that make sense? My husband's standing outside the window. I'm gonna hurt him. He's distracting me. Uh-oh. I'm fixing to have some stuff fall. Where can I put this? Jar of Haunts. This little mummy's so cute. The candy corn. A spooky treat for you to eat. This little teeny tiny spider. The yucky eyeballs, which will be perfect for boys. And the little goo. And you've got the little jack-o'-lantern stem here. So you can stamp the face on here and add that on top. And then it's perfect because you can stamp this in black and this in black. And then this you can color in. Anyway, I love it. Okay, so that is all of the stamp sets. I just got to find a place to put that one. You know what? There is so much stuff in this catalog. Somebody was like, you were like a kid in a candy store. I feel like a kid in a candy store. I seriously do. So I'm going to go over the washi tape next. So this one is the Presents and Pine Cones. This is going to match the paper. This is the Halloween one, which is really awesome. Look at these little bats. And I'm so happy that it has some purple in there. So it has green and pumpkin and purple. Yeah. I like when we have multiple colors. Two or three colors. Three colors is ideal. I love this. What's this called? Candy Cane Lane. Isn't it beautiful? I bought two of those. And then this one is Warmth and Cheer. Okay, so that's the four washi tape. Then let's go through the, this is the Halloween twine. So this is what color? Oh, I can't read. I can't see. I'm not sure what color that is. Gray and orange. Isn't this beautiful? Real red. I don't know if that's red or cherry. It's sparkly. It's beautiful. I wonder if I should, maybe I should take it out. Okay, let's take it out. Because you can't really see through the plastic. See? Oh, I love it. I'll open this one too. See? Peace. No. And then this, what is this stuff called? Metallic thread. I really struggle with this stuff. I don't know why. I do. I love it though. I buy it. But I struggle with it. Okay, so here's the mica flake. So this is going to be perfect for shakers. We've got some Halloween enamel shapes. I love them. They're so beautiful. Yeah, I call this embossing powder. It's glitter. So, no, it is embossing powder. Man, I need my glasses. So, rewind what I said earlier. It is Real Red Glitter Embossing Powder. Are y'all cracking up? We can all laugh about this later. It is embossing powder. It's just glittery embossing powder. Oh, sometimes I scare myself. Aren't these beautiful? So you could actually use this for Christmas. These are Halloween. Or not. I love them. Next is the little teeny tiny jingle bells. So we've got silver and red. Love them. Darling. And they're going to go perfect on the end of these guys' hats. Okay, so next, what are these called? Christmas trinkets. I like that word, trinket. So we've got a gingerbread. I don't know if y'all can see that. Gingerbread. Yes, Melissa, thank you for bringing that up. I didn't want to say it because I was sure people would be sick and tired of me saying I'm allergic to glitter, but I am allergic to glitter. This one's Bells. And this one is a Holly. Is there just three? I did that same thing earlier. I could read the box, but honestly, the font's too little. I like to call it ant size. And then these are Fancy Frost Sequins. They're really pretty. It looks like maybe Sweet Sugar Plum, Pool Party. I don't know. Yeah, I can't read it. It's in the catalog, though. It'll say in the catalog. So, oh, one more ribbon. Oh, I haven't even touched the ribbon. What am I talking about? One more. Here we go. Okay, so this is rope. It's awesome, isn't it? I love it. Look at how big and thick this is. Let's see. Tie a little bow really quick. This is going to be good for making ornaments. Do you guys remember when we made an ornament and we completely covered it with, oh yeah, I do. Here we go. Huh, look how pretty. Can y'all see that? Oh, it just froze? Oh no. Is it still frozen? Somebody leave a comment. Is it still frozen? I still have more stuff to show you. Okay, it's back. Okay. Okay, so I showed you the little rope. So now this is, I got rid of my packaging. Cherry Cobbler, Emerald Envy, and this is ribbon in there. These two are sold together. So you get a little of each. This I love. I put both rolls here in the camera because I love it so much. Yeah, it's going to be so beautiful, and it's red, and it matches this paper. Okay, these two are packaged together as well, and this is that glimmer ribbon, which I actually really like a lot. It's funny. At first, when I saw it the first time we got it, I really didn't think I would like it, and I love it. So, silver and sweet sugar plum. And then this is the one that matches the paisley stuff. I don't know the name of it. Sorry. This is a black ombre ink pad. So it starts dark and then gets lighter towards the bottom. And I don't know why I didn't open this on camera earlier. I think because I was so excited, I was talking 100 miles an hour. You can't really tell by looking at it. But it is. Okay, a couple more accessories and then I'm going to show you the paper. This, you're not going to believe this. This thing is like, I don't know. It's like a weapon. You can knock somebody out with this thing. It's called the Cable Knit Dynamic Texture Impressions Embossing Folder. Okay, so I watched the Stampin' Up! Video on this. And if you need me to send you a link to it, I can. This is one of our, I think this might be our first 3D embossing folder. So normally our embossing folders are much thinner. Let me actually open up one so that you can see the difference. I think these are called 2D, and this new one is called 3D. And this is not a very good example because it's just an outline really. But look at the difference. And you only need to use one plate with this one and not two, whereas normally you use two with these, only one plate. I'm going to have to do a video on that. And sometimes I do videos for my sake, not just y'all's, so that way I don't forget as well. Here's another embossing folder. This is called the Pretty Paisleys. Isn't that pretty? Very elegant. And then we have one more embossing folder. This is the Pine Bow. And the decorative mask. So I have to show you these. So we got the dots. and the lines, like the lines, those thingies, and these. I like these things. Okay, so last but not least is the paper. And I didn't explain this earlier. I did order more stuff. I placed order number one, and I got it overnight so that I could go ahead and start working on my 12 weeks of Halloween series. I needed my product quickly. But I have another order coming next week. I didn't expedite it, and so I ordered stuff like the markers and some more sets. Okay, so my favorite paper is on top, and the name of it is Candy Cane Lane. And isn't this so cute? I'm just like, oh, I could scream. And it coordinates really well with the backside. I always like paper that coordinates front and back, so that way when I make boxes and bags, they don't look like an eyesore. Oh, I hear not Chirpy, Skittles upstairs. I can't believe I just called her Chirpy. I haven't done that in a long time. This side and this side. You sound like the Green Giant up there. Sorry, he's walking really heavy. Sorry about that. If I could have muted it, you know what? It probably froze Teresa because I yelled really loud. Well, I didn't yell really loud. I could yell a whole lot louder. Can y'all still hear me? Yes. How do you order overnight? Mary, there is a little option. When you very first, if you want to email me, I can send you screenshots. But it says regular shipping, or you're given the option of two-day shipping or overnight shipping. So second day air shipping. I actually have a lot of customers that do that because if you live on the East Coast, sometimes it can take an order like 10 or 12 days. And second day shipping is $20 extra. Now the overnight one is a little more than that. Well, actually a lot more. But I really need, every single day right now counts for me. My work days are not as long as they used to be. Okay, anyway, back to the paper. Okay, number one, backside. Number two, backside. Then number three, and the backside. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, we're going to have the cutest Christmas projects this year. I love the paper. So like little peppermints and the backside. And see, they all coordinate. I love it. Little gingerbread man with little hearts and the backside, which coordinates. And oops, I got the wrong piece here. Look how awesome that is. I love that. That's for like dudes. This is for girls. And then this one and the backside. So they all coordinate together. Love it. Love it. Don't y'all love it? See, I say stamp sets are my most favorite, but then I'm like gushing over the paper. So hopefully I held it in the camera for you. Sorry about that. I don't want to forget to show you this one. So next we're going to cover the pumpkin one. Pumpkin. Halloween. I got pumpkin on the brain. Okay, so what's the name of this? I don't know because they tore the name of it off. I don't know. I'll tell you later. Okay, so pumpkin dots coordinate together. I love this one. Let me turn it back over. Okay, so we got the cute little houses and then the back side. I love like the brick wall. That's awesome. David! He's talking to the bird, so I can hear him up there making sounds, and he's encouraging her to make sounds. I'm bird setting. Love this one. I'm getting sidetracked. I'm getting distracted. He's distracting me. And then the next one. Love this one. And look at the little bats. Cute. And they coordinate. Look at here. See? Love it. Love this one. Okay, then we have two specialty paper. So this means they're not two-sided. They're just one-sided. Spider web and then the dots. Do y'all like that one? Oh, see, Deborah? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I know. I actually listen to my customers when they tell me. I feel your pain. Okay, so this one is the presents and pine cones. So remember earlier, what did I say? I think I said that this presents and pine cones washi tape. Yeah, so it matches. Okay. Now, I'll be honest. I'll have to be honest. I'm not much of an Emerald Envy fan. But I do think the paper's pretty. So if you love Emerald Envy, you're going to love this pack of paper. Christmas bells, holly, pine cones. What's on the back side? Whatever that's called. Don't know. Little Christmas trees. And little bows. And stripes. I love stripes. I could see myself using that one for sure. This is the back side. This one's pretty. And then the back side. Now we're going to move to the next one. Oh, this one's fabulous. And I have to say, I can always admit when I'm wrong. And I am wrong a lot. But when I looked at this in the catalog, I wasn't too sold on it. I couldn't really see, in my defense. So I only ordered one pack because I'm like, I don't think I'm going to like it. I'm going to order more. I actually love it. The colors are really beautiful in person. It didn't display well, I don't think, in the catalog. So, and maybe I should have looked at the samples better because I know a lot of the things that I did order, like some of the stamp sets, I ordered because of the samples. So if it had a really cute sample and I could see myself using it, I ordered it. So this is a very beautiful print. And that's the back side. And it does coordinate. So I could use this for a box or a bag. And then next we've got this one. And that's the back side. Don't really coordinate, but it'll be okay. And then this one. I like this one. I like this one a lot too. I could see myself using this one for like the blessing mix. But I love houndstooth. And we have two houndstooth. Look. I love it. Okay, so let's see. I didn't show you the other side. Look how pretty this is. Again, you really have to see it in person. It's way prettier in person, I promise. And it coordinates. And then the final two sheets are more of the specialty paper, which, I don't know. What can I say? Nothing. There we go. So, now, Real Red, 12 by 12. I ordered this because I can make some bigger boxes and bigger bags with 12 by 12. We don't normally carry this anymore. So this is in our holiday catalog. We also have the Halloween pack, which is pumpkin, a basic black, and I don't know if it's, I could actually open it. What a concept. Let's see what colors are in here. Earlier I was saying I thought it was basic gray, but it could be smoky slate. Who knows? And maybe it's just black. You can't depend on my eyes anymore. Let's see. Come on. Yeah, basic gray. It's not even black. Well, it's a good, it's a good thing y'all can't order yet because you'd be looking for black. Well, some of y'all can. Those of you that are demonstrators. Anywho, sorry about that. It's basic gray and pumpkin. I'll have to make sure and put a little note on the earlier video that there's no black in there. So the next pack of paper is called the Fancy Frost Specialty. And this stuff is beautiful. I have a heavy hand, so I kind of sort of struggle with lightly coloring it. But if you're good at that, this is a beautiful pack of paper. I swear, I try every time we get this stuff, and then I ruin it. So I do love it. Maybe I need to go to sponge dabbing school. I don't know. I don't think I have much patience. And am I looking at the wrong side? No. I don't know. I think I was. Yeah, this is the pretty side. Maybe I just flipped it earlier. Oh, now I'm going to get it all mixed up. You can't really see the designs. They're really pretty, though. I mean, really pretty. Yeah, that one's like snowflakes. And this one is, too. He is totally encouraging her to talk up there. Maybe he's trying to tell me to be done. I just made him homemade chicken noodle soup and a peach cobbler, so he can be patient. This right here is the copper foil sheets, and I'm not taking it out because I don't want to ruin it. I want to get fingerprints on it or bend it, but it's copper. Thanks, Angela. I'm glad you like them. I tried to do YouTube earlier, but I couldn't connect. And now we have the pumpkin glimmer paper. Last year we had the black, and this year we have pumpkin. I love it. Okay, we have one more thing that I haven't shown you yet, and then that wraps up everything I ordered this time. So I'll do another live stream when I get my next order. This is called the Warmth and Cheer Designer Series Paper Stack, and there was a stamp set that went with it, kind of, sort of, I think. I don't remember if it was this one or another one. I don't know. It's in the catalog. Well, why don't I start? I always start in the back. I'm a person that starts in the back of the catalog and the back of a magazine. I don't know why. So, I'll just thumb through these. I wish we had a stack of the Candy Cane Lane. I'll be honest. I like this stack, but I would have really liked. But if you look, I think that this, I think you can still use some of these with the washi tape. See? Totally you can. Yeah. It's a nice variety. So you could use some of this for Christmas, and then I think you can use some for fall and Thanksgiving. You know, that could totally be fall. This could be fall. Yeah, that could be fall. Okay, so I think I have shown you everything. Let me check my little stash over here. I did. Okay, so do you guys have any questions you want to ask me? I was kind of trying to look up there. Oh, I think you're right about the stamp set. I just don't know where I put it. Is it right here? Nope, that's not it. I'm going to get my favorite paper back out real quick and put that on the top. That's the most exciting. Carol, I don't know. It could mean something. Something fabulous. I'll put this here, too, for presentation. I do, too. You're welcome. Thank you for joining me. I hope that helped you guys make your decisions. I do have more product coming next week, so I'll show you that. Not nearly as much, just a few other items, but this is plenty to get me started. Yeah, I think it was that set. Let me see if I can find it real quick. I have no clue. How can I lose something that should be right in front of my face? Let's see. I mean, I think I had all of the stamp sets right here in front of me. I don't think I put them anywhere else. Let's see. No. I don't know. Now, see, he got Skittles started, and then now he's gone. Bless her heart. She's up there squawking. She just said beep, beep. Okay, sorry, guys. I can't find it. It's somewhere in here. Okay, so one more minute. I'm going to stay on here. Do you guys have any questions? And what I'll do when I end the video is I'll actually go back and look for any questions, and I'll answer them if you guys left any. I did that this morning after the live stream earlier. Okay, I think that's it. So thank you, guys. Have a good night, and I'll see you soon. How do I end this? Thank you.